I am at the point where I genuinely believe every single person following a vegan diet is covering up an eating disorder. Seeing as the vegan diet is an eating disorder itself, the justification of the lack of nutrition from a vitamin standpoint, as well as caloric standpoint, is nothing short of a cult. How out of touch with reality you have to be to not see the ridiculousness of this diet is outstanding. The young lady we are going to see today is clearly living in her own world, and as I said before, I would love to be reborn as a hot as hell vegan girl with an IQ of 60. They seem blissfully happy and unaware of everything going on around them. I guess it's a combination of that IQ level and depriving their brain of vitamin B12 and fatty acids and other various nutrients. The vegan diet does not provide adequate nutrition in anything. Vitamins, minerals, elements, fatty acids, and that becomes painfully obvious when we see how these people are looking and behaving.
Good morning, guys. Welcome back to my channel. So I'm still in the Seychelles and I thought I'd show you everything I eat in a day on vacation. Super healthy vegan, and I hope it gives you some inspiration how to stay healthy while traveling. It really is not that hard. So yeah, let me show you.
Hey, I gotta give these vegans some credit. They're reasonably good at creating an illusion of health to the average person. From playing the happy, upbeat music, to constantly saying the word healthy. Hey, they even got me going a little bit. But if you look at what they are actually doing, from the foods they're eating, typically being pure sugar, and the massive amount of jump cuts in their video, how they always have to be out in the daylight, because the only form of lighting they look reasonable in is daylight. Things become much clearer. You have to kind of look past the editing, the happy music, all of this BS to actually see what's going on.
So I also wanted to show you guys something that I usually ask for whenever I'm in like tropical places where they have lots of aloe vera plants. So this is just pure natural aloe vera. So what I typically ask for is that they give us like the aloe vera leaves and they cut it already in half, and then you only need to basically take half of the leaf and rub it in your face, and you see like the gel here. This is the pure aloe vera. So this is also what's in my aloe vera juice in London that I put in my water, and it's so hydrating and really like replenish, and especially after the sun it's really cooling and so good for your skin. So yeah, I just rub this in my face. It's like an all natural face mask.
So you take the aloe vera leaf and you just rub like the gel in your face. It's so good. It's so cooling and it's like pure hydration for your skin. So yeah, this is just something to keep in mind.
I'm a little bit confused here. What are we actually replenishing, young lady? Let's see. Reduces wrinkles, hydrates your skin, heals acne. A little bit misleading, but okay. Internal use, relieve constipation, reduces inflammation, stabilizes blood sugar level. Okay, so what aloe vera actually does when you consume it is it makes you shit your brains out and it can cause dysbiosis, which is an imbalance of gut bacteria. I'm glad to see this young lady is no longer drinking the aloe vera in the actual video. In her last video, that's what she was doing. And drinking aloe vera is considered toxic by some people. It's actually dangerous. It's something you shouldn't be doing. It damages your stomach, but hey, anything that damages your body in the context of a vegan diet is known as detox. when your organs and muscle tissue literally turns gray. Oh no, that's just your body detoxing all the bad stuff.
So yeah, this is just something to keep in mind. It doesn't cost anything. Skin feels so good.
You mean it doesn't cost anything after you've already spent a few $1,000s on vacation to a resort?
So I'm at the gym doing a quick workout, and I'm using the Pevolt workouts. It's basically an online platform with all kinds of workouts, and you can choose between ones with equipment or without equipment. Choose a body part you want to do something to keep in mind. So yeah, this is just something to keep in mind. It doesn't cost anything. Skin feels so good. So I'm at the gym doing a quick workout. So yeah, this is just something to keep in mind. It doesn't cost anything. Skin feels so good. So I'm at the gym doing a quick workout, and I'm using the Pevolt workouts. It's basically an online platform with all kinds of workouts, and you can choose between ones with equipment or without equipment. Choose a body part you want to focus on, and most important, they're so easy to do from anywhere. So yeah, I love to do the workouts, especially when I'm traveling. And you also get 30 days of free streaming using my code Caroline. So yeah, try it out. Let me know what you guys think. I love them, and so many of my friends are doing them as well. Yeah, I can really recommend it. You also get 20% off the equipment at their website. Yeah, let me know what you guys think. I hope you try it out because it's really working, and they have all kinds of different levels for beginners, for more advanced workout people.
So this is the website, and then you can choose between all the workouts. I was thinking of doing... They also tell you how long they are, so depending on how much time you have. So this one sounds great with no equipment on the mat. So I'm going to do this one, and then it plays, and it's really easy to follow. They're doing it in real time, so I love that as well.
I mean, I wouldn't really consider getting naked and stretching a workout, but when you don't have energy because of your starvation diet, it makes a lot of sense. And this might actually be a reason where even people on a normal diet, especially women, don't really exercise intensely in the gym. They're inclined to starve themselves because of the modern cultural wisdom of caloric restriction when trying to lose weight. I mean, that's pretty much what this girl is doing here. But when you reduce your protein intake, your fat intake, your overall caloric intake, you barely have the energy to move, let alone perform an intense workout. I'm sure she feels incredibly tired and lethargic. You can notice in the way she's talking, you know, she talks very slow. She pauses between words. But, I mean, hey, maybe I'm just jealous. Maybe I just want to dress up in those cute pink booty shorts and stretch in front of the camera for everyone.
So, giving you guys a little body update. So, yeah, I've been eating a bit more fat in the last few months, and I have gained a little weight. But, yeah, I feel amazing. That is all that matters.
When looking at the physiques of these vegans, it's really unusual. They seem super lean, yet they are still storing adipose tissue on their stomach. This is because of insulin resistance, bloating, essentially consuming a high carbohydrate diet without adequate protein. And even when they are relatively lean and they look attractive by modern standards, you can tell there is no semblance of muscle mass or lean body mass on these vegan people. They are literally unable to build up muscle mass, yet people like bringing up, oh, vegan bodybuilder this, vegan bodybuilder that, I'm getting plenty of protein from lentils and beans as I fought my brains out. In reality, if it was possible to get plenty of protein on a vegan diet and build muscle, why does everyone look like an emaciated stick figure?
Hey guys, so it is 4 o'clock and I am about to have my first meal of the day. So I didn't eat until 4 and I really want to talk about that for a second and tell you the benefits. So it's basically like a longer intermittent fasting thing. So intermittent fasting typically means you don't eat for 16 hours and then you eat for 8 hours. Whenever I travel to the beach or somewhere warm where I'm like tanning, going for a swim, and being in a bikini all day, I do like longer intermittent fasting. So I basically narrow down the hours of the day where I eat to about 4 to 5 hours. And I have seen so many benefits from doing that. I just feel lighter during the day, I have more energy, I have fewer thoughts, I'm more efficient, I get so much stuff done. That's what I do and it works for me, and it has ton of other benefits. If you're looking to lose weight, to clear your skin, this is amazing for your digestion as well. I'm a big fan of that. And what I do when I go to hotels, I order the breakfast and then I just keep it in the fridge, so it's nice and cool for when I'm back and have my meal. And also at 4 o'clock, I feel like I enjoy my meal more because I've done something before. It's not like you wake up and you have breakfast and then you're all tired and stuff. So I kind of feel like I earned my meal and I'm really enjoying it a lot more. Yeah, looking forward to my big fruit meal. So what I do, I have a big fruit meal at 4 and then I have dinner around 7. I'm gonna show you my dinner later.
In the title of this video, it actually says nothing till 4. Freely the Banana Girl actually has something called Raw Till 4, where you only eat raw vegan foods until 4 o'clock and then you can have whatever. I really don't like seeing this woman in a bikini, you know, with the waves crashing against the beach in the background, happy music playing, all tan, you know, essentially encouraging a starvation diet. The reason she feels better, you know, not eating most of the day, is probably because her blood sugar is not fluctuating like crazy, and possibly because she's not feeding the plant-based mold demon in her stomach. When you have a bacterial imbalance or stomach issues, which this girl likely does considering she drinks aloe vera juice, an imbalance of bacteria in your stomach and having too much of one bacteria can cause issues whenever you eat a meal. When you're feeding that bacteria, they release certain toxins and negative substances that can cause brain fog.
So this is what I'm having. So I basically always travel with a big Tupperware glass box. I just put this in my luggage or I have it with me on the flight. So I pack all the fruits from the breakfast in there, and I also had a bit more. So I keep this in the fridge. It's nice, fresh and cold. I still have one green juice, so I'm gonna drink that first. And then I'm gonna start having the watermelon because this is the fruit that digests the quickest. So you wanna have that first. So basically you wanna eat your way up. Start with the fruits that digest the easiest. And watermelon is basically just 90% water. So it's been digested in like 15 minutes. And then I have the honey melon. So I basically eat all the honey melon from that bowl. Then I go to the pineapple, papaya, and mangoes. And I'm also gonna have a few bananas. So I never count calories. I know you guys are very interested in it. So I'm gonna basically just tell you how many calories it has, but I never count it. And I just eat what feels right for me. Seriously, don't worry about calories. Just eat what makes you feel your best. And that's all you have to worry about. Papaya is so good for digestion. Actually, papaya and pineapple are two of the fruits that are richest in enzymes. Really gives your digestion a good kickstart for the day. Watermelon, some mango, and of course some green juice. So I have about 2 bottles a day, sometimes even more.
Watermelon digests quickly. I think what she means is that it enters and leaves the stomach quickly because it actually takes your body a couple of hours to deal with all of the fruit sugar, the fructose. Your liver has to process it, and that is not quick by any means. She doesn't count calories. That is a crazy amount of fruit. The only way she feels good after eating that meal is by getting a sugar rush, and there's no way she feels satiated. It must just be a feeling of fullness from maximizing her stomach capacity. She goes on to mention enzymes in papaya and pineapple, but the enzymes in these foods don't really help you with digestion because they simply don't compare to what our bodies are capable of. Our stomachs are incredibly acidic, and our bodies produce a variety of enzymes that are used to absorb nutrients.
And just giving you a quick look of the view. How nice is that?
Drink that slop. Oh, man.
This juice is celery, cucumber, lemon, ginger, and spinach. So I know everyone's crazy about celery juice, but I have been drinking this juice for so many years and it makes me feel amazing. So yeah, I feel like it has the same benefits. But if you prefer celery juice, it's just as good. It's probably a little tastier because this tastes quite strong, I'm not gonna lie. But yeah, best thing for your skin.
Drinking green juice is the best thing for your skin. I don't think I've ever heard that one before. I'm pretty sure that would be debunked by a 5-year-old child. But I do enjoy the passive-aggressive undertone. Oh, I've been doing this for like 3 years and this makes me feel amazing. But your celery juice might taste a little better because I'm suffering through this nutrition that is making my skin glow.
Really?
Massage and we're having a little island shower. So cozy. I love it when it rains. Yeah, now you know why it's so green here everywhere. Relaxing. I feel like I'm having a massage every day video so far, but it's my favorite thing to do, especially on vacation. So relaxing, so good. So I set myself on fire. Come on. The massage is done now. We're having a little post-massage snack and ginger tea.
Nut snack.
Raw nuts and breakfast. So my dinner starter is also a big plate of fruit. Dinner is ready. So I'm going to show you what I'm having. This is just pure greens. And I want to like wrap all the veggies in the greens. So I make like some little nice wraps. Here I got some baked sweet potatoes. Again, no oil and no salt. Some cherry tomatoes, some more greens, and some avocado.
I don't really see how any of these vegans can say she's not eating enough calories. How can a human being possibly fit any more food into their stomach? The volume of food these vegans are eating is ridiculous. If humans were actually cows, their stomach capacity would be about 5 gallons. That's the equivalent stomach comparison size of a human to a cow. And if you look at how much food these vegans need to eat, you know, their food volume is incredibly high. Imagine just having a steak with a side of butter. That's literally the equivalent to as many calories as this girl ate today, yet I'm sure it's like 3 to 5% of the physical volume size. If that isn't enough of a signal from nature telling you what foods humans should be eating, then I really don't know how to explain it. How are you going to say that you can go into nature, harvest all these fruits, vegetables, prepare them, eat that incredible amount of food all day? It's not actually physically possible. So thank you guys for joining me today. It needs to be made much clearer to the general population that veganism is simply an eating disorder for people that like cute, cuddly animals. Maybe I should start wearing my bunny ears more often, putting on some cute animal suits, and vegans would start liking me. So if you guys can please like, subscribe, hit that bell icon, and share the video if you can. If you guys would like to support me further, check out some of the other videos on my channel. In addition to that, I've recently launched Frankie's Free Range Meat, our goal to provide you guys with high-quality, nutrient-dense animal foods. Maybe next time this young lady is traveling on vacation, she can order one of our non-perishable jerky and pemmican packages. For merely $100, you can sustain yourself for one whole week off of our pemmican and jerky. It is a native indigenous travel food. It's non-perishable, super calorie dense, super nutrient dense, especially when you're drinking green sludge for your nutrition. Again, thank you guys for joining me. Enjoy the rest of the weekend.